This attack brings back memories of the 1996 bombing at the Atlanta Olympic Games. USA Today sports columnist Christine Brennan was in her hotel room overlooking Olympic Parks when the blast went off, and Christine joins me now. Christine, it must have brought back pretty awful memories of what happened in Atlanta for you.
Oh, it did, Piers. In fact, when I first watched the video that we've seen over and over of the blast 12 seconds apart, the sound hit me, the sound from my TV set watching the video yesterday. And I said, boy, I've heard that sound before. And it was that night, early in the morning, actually, in July of 1996. The media hotel was right next to the Olympic Park, and a band was playing, and I had just come back from the swimming venue, was getting my notes together for the next day, and I heard this explosion. I looked out the window, and my first thought was maybe it was part of the act of the band, the sound, the noise, and I kept looking, and of course, within a few minutes, a few seconds, actually, I started seeing the police cars and the column of emergency vehicles that were coming to the Olympic Park.
There were obviously a lot of changes made to security at major American sporting events after what happened in Atlanta. And you could argue we've been very, very fortunate. There's not been any more terrorist outrage at a sporting event since then in the United States. There's been one now. Do you think there'll have to be even more stringent security going forward in most of these sporting fixtures now?
Piers, I do think that, although when you think about most stadiums, you know, you go into in the United States, around the world, you often go through metal detectors. Fans do, the media do. Now tickets have barcodes. There's certainly more security when you go into a sporting event than there, say, is going into a shopping mall or a movie theater. And I think that makes a lot of sense. And it goes even back to the 1972 Olympics in Munich, where the 11 Israeli athletes and coaches were killed September 5th, 1972. So from that moment on, the Olympics started to have stringent security. That was a good 20 to 30 years even before most stadiums did. But a marathon, your other guests have mentioned this, 26 miles, 385 yards. Mm. How in the world can you, you cannot guarantee that all that length, that entire distance in a city will be safe?
No, you can't. Sports obviously hugely competitive, but there's been some really touching moments today. We saw the Yankees paying tribute to the Red Sox and the Chicago Tribune to all the Boston teams, a very special tribute there in the paper. But the Yankees one in particular, Christine, really struck me because I'm a diehard Arsenal soccer fan. And I was just trying to picture a scene where under any circumstances we would play the rival Tottenham Hotspurs anthem or song. And I would find it pretty hard to believe that any British soccer team would do that. This must have been a pretty extraordinary thing for the Yankees.
Absolutely. Sweet Caroline, the Red Sox theme song being played at Yankee Stadium. And I when I first heard about this, I got a tear in my eye as I watched the video. And I think it speaks to how we do come together. It sounds like a cliche. And boy, I wish we never had to discuss this again. But we do rally and we do come together. And all of a sudden, Yankees, Red Sox means almost nothing. It's such a fierce rivalry. But right now, they're all together as one. And I think that was a wonderful moment at Yankee Stadium.
It most certainly was. And to give you an idea of the global impact of this story, at Arsenal tonight, actually, they played a game today. They had a minute silence for the victims in Boston. And I'm sure that's being replicated in sports arenas all over the world. Christine, thank you very much for joining me.
Piers, thank you.